Hey, is this the place where you can get a job to make people sick? And the guy's like, yeah.
Students in Scott Comstock's scientific communications class are critiquing the product of their semester-long exploration of the role of bacteria in the health of soil.
Okay, now warm feedback.
I like how he asked for a job to make people sick, because you wouldn't like normally think that, but since right. The bacteria does that, it makes sense.
Each student produced a unique soil superhero pamphlet, which integrated science, art, history, math, language arts, and multimedia. A team of seventh grade teachers at King Middle School began planning the project during a three-day summer session.
At the beginning of every expedition, we usually look at a district calendar to see, you know, what we're going to be doing for the fall. Then we start zooming in a little bit on exactly what it looks like from September through, say, December. And we'd X out some days we wouldn't be here. And then we kind of, what I like to call maybe bracket the time of a kickoff through the culminating event and the celebration of the final product. This is where we start as a staff, is creating the model before we ask the kids to do it. So essentially we kind of run ahead 7 to 9 weeks in advance and figure out what exactly we're going to build. So here's a good example of an informational pamphlet around bacteria. There's like a science piece around metabolism, and that's a science content piece. Here's a math piece around size of their bacteria. This is a multimedia piece where the kids have drawn their work, characters, text, and background, and then they would scan it, and then they would bring that in. So we did that first to see how challenging that would be for the kids.
Do we have some flexibility?
The scientists were all like, whoa, sure, we'll come. You know, so they're all very excited to do this.
In expeditionary learning, we love to develop relationships between the students and community members, because the excitement that it generates in the students deepens their learning and lengthens their retention.
There's a word that you might not know, the word is soluble. In other words, it's able to be dissolved by water. Ruth contacted me and says, you know, I want to do this thing with the kids about soil bacteria, but I don't know a lot about microbiology. So we sat down over the summer and we probably talked 7 or 8 hours. And she read microbiology textbooks, and she did a lot of learning on her part.
One of our ideas was to create a comic to kind of jazz up and make bacteria colorful and exciting for the kids, but to also teach them about the benefits of bacteria and soil scientifically. And so we brought in an expert who showed them how to make something come alive through illustrating it.
Today we're working with Annie O'Brien, a comic book artist, and she's teaching us how to make expressions.
They can be a line.
And we learned how to draw some eyes and some mouths so we can make good facial expressions.
And they would start storyboarding out different ideas to start coming up with this little story about habitat and setting. So we're taking the content, making it exciting for the kids, and having them make a mini product like in a comic life situation on a laptop. If they're creating a character for their comic life, they'll do something like this. They'll blackline it, they'll color it, they'll scan it, and then we'll pop it over here into a folder called drawings, and then here's their character and here's their situation. They can go over that on the district server, bring it back to their workspace on their desktops, and start to manipulate that. As we get so much digital information in the computer, we have to start organizing. So typically we'd have something like this that we'd create, where we'd have a major folder, and we'd have social studies, science, math folders in that, which would house the social studies information, the science information. So when it was time to create the product, we knew exactly where to go.
Do you guys know how to get to the King Middle School website?
Yeah.
It doesn't work well when you ask kids to learn new technical skills at the same time you're asking them to master content. So what we do is we scaffold it so that we're asking them to learn a new set of technical skills around content that isn't hard for them. We might ask them to produce an organizational structure around shooting letters of the alphabet in the building. It's content they already understand. Scott asks them to learn the file structure that they're going to use in their final product for their expedition well in advance of ever thinking about how bacteria and pamphlets are going to be put together. So it's a matter of being smart about how you plan your teaching, scaffolding, collaborating with your team members, and giving kids the confidence to build meaningful products around deep content.
When I ask the other students to move out, you're going to slide into their spot, open up, and show the scientist your particular piece that you're working on improving.
During the learning expedition, students present their work and get feedback from outside experts.
Okay, a denitrifier is a superstar when bacteria collect organic nitrogen formed in the biosphere, that's correct, and then it breaks the compound down to decompose it. I like how you're breaking the sentences up and making it really easy to understand.
As part of a culminating event, students distribute their pamphlets to local garden centers, universities, and at the main flower show.
There's assessment embedded in everything that we do all the way along, but that final product is out there, and it's going to be celebrated, and it's going to be shared with the community, and it's exciting. You know, we get to hold the kids to that, we get to hold ourselves to that, and someone said once, if it's worth doing, it's worth doing well, and that's kind of our thoughts around that.
Grammar, spelling, punctuation, we'll just think about those things.
Okay.
And thank you very much, Kaylee.
For more information about what works in public education, go to edutopia.org.